scientific method is a way of acquiring knowledge through observation and experimenting. There are certain steps that scientists follow to acquire knowledge. These steps are pretty consistent, and the good thing about them that if a scientist follow them thoroughly, they will be sure about the results. Because in scientific method and following these steps, we will make sure that our data is independent of what we want, of our feelings, of our mood, whether we are hungry or sad or happy or any other external factor. All of these factors will not affect the way we are collecting the data and the way we are analyzing the data. The first step usually of scientific method is observation. And observation can come through different ways. It depends on the field. We can observe animal behavior. We can observe human behavior. We can observe cells under microscope. We can observe plant. We can observe planets, atoms, and so on. So we have different areas of science. Each area has its own way of observing. Now, when we come across an observation that triggers curiosity, that where the scientific method starts. We will come up with the what if question, and from that point we will start to build up that process and going through its steps. Usually after observation we need to develop a hypothesis, and the hypothesis would be our best attempt to explain this observation, why this happened or why it might be going in this direction, or why this is going to be true or why this is not going to work, and so on. A hypothesis would be based on our prior knowledge, this knowledge acquired through literature, through prior experiments that we have done. And as I said, this is going to be our best attempt to explain this observation. We need to make sure that our explanation of this phenomenon is accurate. And that is where we need to sit and to plan for an experiment. And basically, planning an experiment, or what they call a device, a testable production, is very tough a process sometimes, because we don't know where are we going to end. We don't know what the data would look like. So it's kind of navigating through different scenarios, different options, and try to find the most logical one as a start point. Devising a testable production, it means that I'm going to make an experiment and I'm going to predict about its results. Say, for example, if I want to test common cold virus, I would say if I subjected healthy individuals to common cold virus, they will develop common cold symptoms. So this is a testable prediction. I am making a prediction that healthy individuals will develop common cold symptoms after exposed to a virus. However, untestable prediction would be something I cannot test, I cannot verify. Saying, for example, if I exposed healthy individuals on the moon to common cold virus, they will get common cold symptoms. I can't test that because I don't have the capabilities to send people to moon and test the virus over there. After that, I will do the critical experiment. And usually the critical experiment is different sets of experiments. Each one of these experiments is going to answer a specific question about this hypothesis. Sometimes I need to do more than one experiment because the hypothesis has different angles. After getting the data, I will start analyzing the data. I will start revising them and modify my hypothesis. Did it work? Didn't work? And what can I do about it? After concluding my experiment, I will start making the revisions. I will start making corrections. I will see if I need additional experiments, and usually that's the case, to answer more questions came out of the experiment, because science process is a continuous process. Every time you answer something, you will get more questions to answer, and so on. However, the process itself will guarantee that my data is accurate to the best of my knowledge, to the best of my ability. And if there is any other scientist is going to repeat my experiment, they will get the same results. basically scientific method is very rational process, concrete process. It will guarantee that the knowledge we are building on is accurate as long as this process is